Hi everyone, welcome to or back to my channel. My name is Camila Best. If you're new here, I just graduated high school and today I'm going to be sharing with you guys my best advice for all my high school students. This video is going to be long. I'm going to be covering a bunch of different things, so I will have timestamps for specific subjects that you guys want me to cover in the description so you don't have to watch something that you are not interested in. So high school is tough. It's a lot. You actually like grow and change more than you're expecting, and I had a major turning point in the middle of it. There are a lot of things that I learned the hard way. Before I start, I want to explain to you guys the type of student I was so that you understand where I'm coming from or you can relate or not relate. I moved around a lot, so I always had a language barrier, and I also have learning disabilities, so school was always really, really hard for me. And I kind of just took the title of being the dumb kid in class, you know, I just didn't understand anything. In terms of friends, I always had friends, you know, a friend group. I switched friend groups a lot. I was not like the popular girl. I was just chilling. I was always just like with my friends and doing my own things. So what I really want to share with you guys is how I became a good student and how to do that yourself. Basically, why you should try in high school. A lot of things came to me towards the end of my sophomore year. I decided that semester to not get any C's. And then the summer before junior year, I matured even more. And then from that point on, I just decided to get straight A's. And since then, I've been a straight A student. It's really all about how you think about school. First, school needs to be your number one focus, your number one priority. That was kind of forced onto me because my sophomore year, my friend group split up and I was going through a really hard time. And so I didn't enjoy lunch and brunch and after school as much as I did before. I was kind of happy that I had a class with like no one that I knew and like something else to put my focus towards. I slowly realized that if I actually put in the effort, if I actually focus on what I have to do, I can do good. So that's how I decided to just not get C's. The next thing I realized is basically why I was at school, because it was so easy for me to just be like, oh, I hate school. Like, everything I learned, they're so useless. I'm not gonna need any of this. And I heard this a lot, that you're at school to learn how to learn. But I didn't understand it. I would have had an easier time understanding physics if I understood biology, if I gave it a try. You're learning how to learn. You're learning how you are as a student. You're learning what to do when you don't understand something, how to get past it, and you're working out your brain. You're creating new connections. You're learning how to like put things together. Even if you don't need to learn how to do algebra, it's not gonna help you in life. It will help you to know how to learn something as complicated as algebra. Now, the next thing is what really, really helped me the most. It took me a long time to understand this, and I know so many people that still don't get it. First of all, there's no such thing as being smart and being dumb. It's not supposed to be easy. Like, I really had a hard time understanding that because there were students in my class that they just would understand things really easily. And so to me, I was like, oh, they're smart. They're getting this. I'm not. This is not for me. And I would just like check out. And when the teachers would talk and teach and give a lesson, I didn't feel like they were teaching to me. I didn't feel like they were talking to me. But it's not supposed to be easy. You're supposed to struggle. You're supposed to not understand, because you need to know, like the last point, you need to know how to get past that. And at the end of the day, it's you're the one that's responsible for that, not your teachers and not your level of smartness, because that's not even a thing, guys. But what will make you a good student is not being smart, it's being self-disciplined. I gained a lot of self-discipline throughout high school, and that's what got me straight A's, and that's what got me the confidence to take harder classes. I really only learned about self-discipline because I wanted to improve my health, my mental health, my, you know, being productive or whatever. It had nothing to do with school. and I heard a podcast, and he talked a lot about discipline equals freedom and how you need to be strict on yourself and you need to motivate yourself. And so a lot of people made videos off of what he says and their morning routines or whatever. And so before junior year, like a week before junior year, I started waking up at 5 in the morning and working out and eating healthy, and I had a whole specific routine, meditating, and eventually that kind of became part of my life. Having that self-discipline and being able to push myself just became part of my life, and I was able to put that into school. If I can do all of this stuff in the morning that I never thought that I could do, I can get straight A's. Like, I can apply this to anything. If you're sitting there and thinking, I just can't do this because I'm not smart, you need to gain some self-discipline and get yourself together and just do it. The last tip on how I became a good student, this has more to do with what helped me motivate myself and gain that discipline when I really felt like I couldn't do this, I couldn't solve this problem, I couldn't take this test. And it's the fact that I am extremely fortunate to be getting my education. This might speak to a few people that are watching, but I'm an immigrant. My parents are immigrants, and where I was born, my parents were also immigrants. So I learned the process that my dad had to go through and everything that he did to give me this opportunity of having an education and all the doors that it's gonna open. And for me to take it for granted and for me to sit there and think that I can give up on this assignment when my dad went through all of that, for me to be here just seems so selfish and so ignorant, because I know that there are so many people that would just dream to have my education. I don't necessarily mean like you don't need to take it seriously because you can go to college and get a good job. You don't have to go to college, but like getting a decent high school education is something you need to be grateful for. And when you struggle, you can't just give up like that, because people had to work hard for you to be in the position that you're in. And it's not necessarily to make my parents proud, but it's kind of for myself. So yeah, those are all the things that I had to understand and learn. Yeah, I really want you guys to know that it's about the way that you think, because I literally just changed the way that I thought. The next part that you guys really wanted me to go over is like study techniques, time management. Once you decide that you want to be a good student, and once you decide you want to put your full effort into school, that's the first step, and then later you learn what's most effective for you. But I will share with you guys what helped me out. The first thing when it comes to taking notes, every person is different. I really enjoyed using colors and taking different kind of notes. When I would study, I'd have like notes on my laptop, on paper, I would make drawings, I would use Quizlet, I would use like index cards. I literally tried it all, and for some subjects that were really complicated, I had to use all those methods at once for one test. My therapist explained it to me as like your brain's like entryway is like a triangle for, you know, this concept to get in, but it's coming in as like a big square and it just doesn't fit in, and you have to take that square and shape it into a triangle so it fits in so you can understand it and use it to make different connections. What saved me so much time and helped me understand things so much better right away was preparing. Let's say I'm thinking of like the classes I took my senior year. This is in psychology. My teacher would post the entire presentation with all the lectures and all the things we're gonna be learning. So I would make a Google Doc and start off my notes, you know, have the titles, have the different big things we're gonna go over, and then have bullet points, which is where I would be inserting information that I would get during class. Some teachers would post them online, others did not wanna post them, so I would tell them, I need you to send me them because I need to get an overview and a feel and a look of what we're gonna learn so that in class I feel more prepared. And with math, I would do like my math homework from that day, and then I would look at the lecture for tomorrow and kind of just look at what's gonna be easy for me, what's gonna be hard for me. And like I said, I would already have my notes ready. I would circle or star parts that I'm like really confused on, so I know I'm gonna have to pay extra attention. I know I'm gonna ask some questions. Also, asking questions and asking your teachers for help is the best thing you can do. This was what I started doing my senior year, and it doesn't even take that much time, and it's actually gonna save you so much time, because after the lecture after that day, I'm saying lecture as if it's college, but like after the lesson that day, I would already understand everything and I would be able to do my homework. When in like junior year where I wouldn't prepare, I would just go into class and it'd be so much information thrown at me. I'd be so confused. I'd have to go home and relearn it over and over and over again until I understood it by myself, which takes so much longer before I was comfortable trying the homework. The other thing is kind of time management. You really want to space out the way that you study because things build off of each other. And it's just like scientifically proven that you learn better and things stick better in your mind if you learn it and then you just reinforce that and like practice and practice and practice. A lot of you guys asked how to not procrastinate, and to me what it was really helpful was I would have things that I really wanted to do that day, like edit a video, and I would only let myself do it after I did my work. I was always a really organized person, so at the beginning of the week, like, I had a planner, I had my Google Calendar, and then I had, like, a Google Sheets thing where I would plan out what day I was gonna do what assignment. Kind of plan out your week in a way where you can space out what you're learning so that it really sticks in your brain well and you don't end up procrastinating and cramming. Okay, so that is basically it for the school part of high school. Next, we're gonna move on to the social part of high school. I'm gonna start off by saying I started high school with no friends. Like, I did not have a friend group, nothing. I had like two best friends in eighth grade. One of them moved and the other one was going to another school. So I was kind of doing everything by myself, but I found people to be with during lunch and brunch, you know, people that I slightly knew. And those were like friendships that lasted a short amount of time, and through them I met other people. So my first tip is, if you're wondering how to make friends, for me, I always made friends through two different ways. One, through other people, and that's a really, really easy way to make friends because, you know, you already have something in common. You have that person in the middle. You have an easy way to start talking to them. However, you don't know those people right away. You might just get into a friendship with without knowing them like that. So those can get complicated. However, it's still natural. And to me, as long as like the friendship is natural and it comes naturally, it's a good friendship. And then the other way to meet people is through interests, people that have similar interests and morals than you. And so this is a little bit harder because I feel like, let's say you are in a sport or you are in a club, some of those people are already in groups, and so it takes a long time before you spend so much time with them that you actually want to spend time together outside of that activity. But if that does happen, those friendships are really, really good because you already know that person, you know, you see them a lot, you already know what they're about, and by the time you're friends, it's like you know you can trust them. The next piece of advice is huge. I've never heard anyone say this in like a high school advice video, or no one ever told this to me, but it's something that I realize now, like right now after high school, and it's be open to new friendships. The thing is, when you have no friends and you meet someone, you look at the good in them. You try to find positive things about them because you're looking for friends. And so you give them a chance. But when you're settled in a group of friends and you're super comfortable and you meet someone, you don't really give them a chance. You're not really like trying to see if you can become friends with them because you already have your friends that you're comfortable with and you think you're gonna be friends forever. You miss a chance to become good friends with an amazing person. And I know that now because there's so many people in my high school that like I sort of talked to or had a conversation with towards the end, and I'm like, why did I never try to become friends with this person? Like, why did we? And it's because they were comfortable in their friend group and I was comfortable in my friend group. And sometimes if you have a friend group and there's like one person that you're meeting, you might have even a negative opinion about them because of what you've heard from the people that you're now friends with. Which, by the way, like, don't start rumors. I never had like drama or like bad blood with people, and when things would go down, no one would ever like come at me and think that I was talking negatively about them. Like, everyone just knew that I would never do that. So that's what I'm saying, try to keep that mindset, because the next thing is that sometimes you need to let go of those you need to let go of. And it happens a lot, you know, you switch friend groups during high school and it's normal. If you're changing and you want to become friends with other people, that's completely fine. There's no need to have bad blood with that person that's like leaving or spending more time with someone else, because they're changing. They're supposed to change and grow and find their personality. But the thing is, if you're way too comfortable in your friend group and you really are like so unrealistic and you think you're gonna be friends forever and you don't need to pay attention to anyone else, eventually you will change and you're gonna be in that position that so many kids in high school are, where it's like they don't like their friends that much anymore, but they have no one else because they never gave anyone else a chance. And then the last piece of information when it comes to friendships and all of that is to be your own person. Don't be known for the group that you're in. Don't, like I said, don't get too comfortable in your friend groups. Have your own things going on. Be your own person, like I always say. Stay true to yourself. So that way, when you feel the need to change friend groups, when you feel the need to change the way you do something, you're comfortable doing it. Don't be so stuck in like, this is my friend group. This is what they all like to do, so I need to do this. Moving on. Another thing a lot of you guys wanted me to go over is what to do in high school when you're really stressed or when you are going through hard times. First of all, that is bound to happen. That will definitely happen. And the first thing that I can tell you guys is that time heals. And I'm not saying this because I want you guys, like, if you're going through something, just think, oh my God, like, there's a light at the end of the tunnel. No, like, if you are going through something, go through it. Like, it's fine. If you ever think that you're gonna be there forever, no. Like, you're gonna look back at that moment. It's not gonna stay like that forever, and you just need to let time do its thing. The next thing that I am still learning, which is to be honest with yourself and with others when you're going through something. So I was always honest with myself. I always knew, like, I'm having a stressful time. I need a break. When it comes to school, like, if you really can't put your focus in school because of other things that are going on, communicate that with your teachers and your counselor. That was so helpful for me. They were able to help me later. I always felt like, oh, I can't talk to them, like, I have to take the test anyways, they're not gonna like make it easier for me. But one time I was like having a really hard time and I went to a teacher and I told him, listen, I'm gonna try to study for the test that we have this week, but I'm going through something right now. And after that test, you know, I took the test, I did bad on that test, but he helped me get my grade up. They have a little bit more flexibility if you communicate with them. That's one thing. And so from that, I want you guys to understand that if you're going through hard times, stressful times, don't think that you need to get over it so you can put your focus in school. School can wait, okay? School can wait and you can recover. Like, give yourself a chance to pick yourself back up. And I'm not saying, like, just let yourself go, you know? Don't fake that you're okay when you're not okay. And another thing that was really, really helpful for me is to have a safe space or a safe person. So I took Focus on Success, which was a class that helped me, and I always had the same teacher and we were really, really close. And I never really like opened up to her when I was going through things, but I would spend time in that classroom because I would just get so much peace just being there, talking to her about whatever, you know? She would just help me calm down. Miss Ellen, if you're watching this, I love you. So yeah, have that safe space. You know, your freshman year, if you go through something, find that one teacher that you're most comfortable with and make that your safe space and your safe person. Okay, next thing we're gonna be talking about are high school relationships. So yeah, you guys wanted to hear about how my high school relationships were, what I think about them. If you guys watched my girl talk, then you probably already know, like, my opinion about high school relationships. I believe that they are learning experiences. I always have to say this when I talk about this with people. Of course, there are high school sweethearts. Of course, there are exceptions. But, you know, during high school, like, you're kids. You don't really know what you're doing, what you're getting yourself into. But you're gonna learn a lot. So if you are going into a high school relationship, or if you want one, just know, first of all, it's not what it looks like. Be realistic with it. And so because it's a learning experience, try whatever. Like, you're in high school. If you wanna try out a relationship, try out a relationship. If you wanna be a player, be a player. But, you know, this is a time for you to try out different things. But Be honest, okay? Don't be telling people you have different intentions than what you do have, and be honest with yourself. When I was like a freshman, sophomore, all I wanted was a boyfriend. Like, I thought relationships looked so amazing. And I talked to guys that had different intentions, and a lot of the time, like, they were lying to me, and a lot of the time they were literally telling me that they wanted nothing to do with me like that. But I would just, like, not be honest with myself and think that I was cool with that. Then I got into a relationship and I, you know, was realistic. I didn't like being in a relationship. I didn't like the feeling of being in a relationship, and I wasn't ready for such a serious thing. It was more serious than I was expecting it to, and I wasn't ready for that. So yeah, and then I was a senior and I tried out a bunch of different types of stuff. You really don't know as much as you think you know. You're gonna struggle in a relationship in high school because you are both kids. Next, one thing that I wanted to go over is money. I'm not the best with money, but it is something that I wish I would have heard. One, try to save your money and make money, because that experience is really good. Having a job or an internship, internships are amazing, really great experiences. It gives you responsibilities, you know, to manage your money. It gives you safety for the future. Next is learn about money, learn about economy, learn about things that you're going to need to know. I don't think they teach it that well in school, so you're gonna have to do your own research. But like, figure out what a credit score is, what you're gonna have to do to have a good credit score, how you're gonna, you know, things that eventually you're gonna run into. Start gaining a little knowledge on it now. Next, I'm gonna be talking about college applications. I feel like this is such a huge thing, but I'm gonna talk about, like, personally the biggest things that I learned or that I did that might help some of you guys out. Freshmen and sophomores, don't worry about it. Like, I know they try to pressure you to start worrying about college. Like, no, worry about high school. You're in high school right now. Worry about the classes that you're taking right now. Definitely, if you're a freshman or a sophomore, take classes for credit. You know, get all that credit that your school requires you to get in order to graduate out of the way fast. I know it sucks because you want to try new things and take different electives, but that's what extracurriculars are for. And I didn't do a lot of that. I wish I would have done a bunch of different things. And when it comes to grades, they like kind of matter for your GPA. They do matter, but like overall, as long as you make your grades improve throughout high school instead of go down, it's great. Just don't make it so hard on yourself to do better later on and have to like recover from how bad you did. Now for 11th and 12th graders, listen up. When I was making my college list, what I found really useful is to look at locations first. So I knew kind of like where I wanted to be, and then in those locations I would look for schools that had what I wanted to study, and then I would just compare their campuses and have my list. So, you know, because you've got to be realistic. Like, there might be a great school, but it might be in the middle of nowhere and you realistically do not see yourself there. Don't apply there. Don't put that on your list. The next thing is you want to start narrowing down your interests, more specific things that you're interested in, and a lot of the time you have more flexibility with your schedule, so you can take classes that are more geared to what you're interested in. It's better, like, it looks better if you take something that you're interested in and that like ties well with the extracurriculars you've been doing and the other class you're taking, instead of just a random like AP class just to get your GPA up. That doesn't say much about you. Like, you really want to create a path that eventually would lead you to your major or what you end up doing. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna talk about is like a personal opinion, but the way that I like ranked my schools, I know a lot of people have like their reach schools or safety schools and their target schools. I ranked them on like how much I liked them, because I didn't have safety schools. I didn't have schools that I was like, okay, fine, if I get into. I only had schools that I loved. Personally, I think it's better, instead of to have safety schools, to just have community college as an option. Community college is really smart because you would save a lot of money and end up transferring to maybe even a better school than what was the top of your list, instead of just going to school that you don't even like. Okay, next is I'm gonna talk about essays, because my GPA was decent, but what really helped me out was my essay. First of all, if you don't know this, your essay, like, write about something that makes you stand out but also speaks to who you are. And my biggest tip is don't write your life story. Write about a specific thing because you have a word limit. A really good college would never let in a student that can write about their whole life in 600 something words. I don't remember the limit. Write about something short and specific that speaks to who you are, but doesn't like literally explain who you are. And the next tip, ugh, this is so good. First of all, start off early, so like the summer before your senior year. Find out the different types of essays you're gonna have to write. Start preparing for that, organizing yourself. I had my essay, like the rough draft, like really, really rough draft, done before my senior year. So then I had that entire semester to ask teachers for help. It completely changed because one of my teachers told me that I needed to make it less than 400 words or something like that, like make it extremely short. Just like unconsciously, when you have to read a bunch of like applications or a bunch of papers, like in school too, if you see one that is short, you're like way more excited and you're paying way more attention because, you know, it's short. And those are basically all of my tips for high school. I wanted to answer some specific questions and share some advice that others have given for you guys. What should I buy? I didn't talk about school supplies. If you're shopping for school, start off with one thing of each. I know I was like super obsessed with like shoving my backpack with like thing, like essentials, just in case. And then by the end of my sophomore year, I hurt like the parallel muscles in my back. And I was just carrying so much stuff I did not need and I couldn't wear a backpack for the rest of that year. So do people actually care about popularity? It's just not like how it is in the movies, but some people do care about that. Those people are insecure, don't even bother with them. But like I said, like give everyone a chance. If you think that someone is way more popular than you and they would never want to be friends with them, just get to know them as if like you're on the same level as them. At the end of the day, we're all like the same. How do you tell a boy in high school that you like him? I think the best thing is to start flirting. If you like someone, start flirting with them and kind of just see how they react. And then just send hints like here and there. Just see how they react and eventually do it. Don't really come out of nowhere. But also like be confident in yourself where you can like say stuff like that, okay? Should you play a sport in high school or is it too much of a distraction? I definitely think you should play a sport in high school. A lot of the time, you know, you can get extra help. And it will just really, really help you to learn how to manage your time. What do you do if someone spreads rumor about you slash tries to start drama? Like I said, just avoid that at all costs. It's a waste of time. Ignore them. If they want that kind of stimulation or entertainment for themselves, they can find it somewhere else. Not here, sweetie. We don't care. We know ourselves and we are not gonna let these people phase us. We're gonna be unbothered in high school. You need to be unbothered. Okay, now I'm gonna go over some tips. So somebody said get senior friends. I mean, yeah, it's helpful if, you know, you get friends that can drive and they will give you good advice and, you know, like they know the teachers. So start with good grades. Like, don't slack off from the beginning. That way it's okay a little if you mess up. That's just like I was saying before. Try to maintain, like, be good, put in full effort at all times so that if you need that safety space to not do so good here and there when you're going through hard times, you have that. Focus on school. Go to class and actually be committed to it. Don't just mess around because this is really all about the future. Yeah. And honestly, I look back and regret so much and it missed a lot of opportunities for me. So just focus and don't go messing around. Just stay on the grind and only have a few real friends because everyone's fake and they're not going to be there for you after high school. So a lot of great tips. Don't try to just be friends with someone just because you want to be friends with them. If they don't add anything to your life, if they're fake, don't bother with them. If you have a hard time focusing, have friends that will push you. That's very much true. At the end of the day, it is all about you because I remember when I was doing bad in high school, I had friends that were doing really, really good. It didn't really affect me, but when I was trying to do better, they really helped to push me. And eventually, like, I was more secure and confident in myself academically. And so it didn't really matter what type of friends I had because I knew that if school was my number one priority. So talk to whoever you want to. Don't worry about what others might think. That is so, so true. And I wish so many people were told this because I feel like a lot of guys wanted nothing to do with me because of the way their friends saw me. You know, and it happens all the time. Like, you just have a bad perspective on someone because you think your friends might think badly. Like, come on, worry about yourself. Like I said, be your own person. Like, do you have any advice for high schoolers?
Take care of your mental health. Mental health is just, it's really important for your performance in school.
Yeah, true. Okay, so that is it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I really hope it helped some of you guys out. Let me know if you have any other questions in the comments. I'll respond. If you're starting off high school, I wish you the best. Really, don't be so scared. It's gonna be so much fun and hard at the same time, but it'll be fun. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to watch more. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. I love you so much. Stay true to yourself, and I'll see you next time. Bye.